My name is Dawn Keene from the Center for Health and Healing. I'm going to do a guided meditation today, one of my favorites about the mountain. The music I do not own the rights to. I'm using Liquid Mind today. And the meditation is from Jon Kabat-Zinn, and you can find that on mindfulescapes.com. Welcome. I want to start off by saying that you are whole, complete, worthy, enough, and loved. Your confidence comes from connecting inside of you of who you are and what you want in life. Please know that whatever life obstacles and challenges are sent your way are teachings that will help you to be stronger and wiser. You will not only survive, you will use these teachings and thrive. So let's begin. Make yourself in a comfortable position. For this meditation, I recommend sitting up. So sitting up, close the eyes. Allow the eyes to gently close and bring your attention to the flow of your breathing. Feel each inhale and each exhale. Just observe your breathing without trying to change or regulate it in any way. Allow the body to be still and sitting with a sense of dignity, a sense of resolve, a sense of being complete, whole. In this very moment, with this posture reflecting this sense of wholeness, as you sit here, picture in your mind's eye, as best you can, the most beautiful mountain you have ever seen or can imagine. Just holding that image and feeling of the mountain in your mind's eye and letting it gradually come into greater focus. Observe its overall shape, its lofty peak high in the sky, the large base root in the rock of the earth's crust, or its steep or gently sloping sides. Notice how massive it is, how solid, unmoving, how beautiful from both afar or up close. Perhaps your mountain has snow at the top of the trees, or frozen river on the lower slopes. Perhaps it has one predominant peak or a series of peaks or a high plateau. Observing it and noting its qualities, when you feel ready, see if you can bring the mountain into your body so that your body sitting here in this moment and the mountain in your mind's eye become one. As you sit here, you share in the massiveness and the stillness and the majesty of the mountain. You become a seated, unmoving mountain. Rooted in the seated posture, your head becomes a lofty peak, supported by the rest of the body, affording you a panoramic view. Your shoulders and arms, the size of the mountain. Your buttocks and legs, the solid base, rooted to your cushion or chair. experience in the body a sense of uplift from deep within your pelvis and spine. With each breath, as you continue sitting, become a little bit more like a breathing, still mountain. Unwavering in your stillness, completely what you are, beyond words and thoughts, a centered, unmoving, rooted presence. As you sit here, becoming aware of the fact that the sun travels across the sky, the light and shadows and colors are changing virtually, moment by moment, in the mountain's gentle stillness. Night follows day, and day follows night. A canopy of stars, the moon, and then the sun. Through it all, the mountain just sits, experiencing change in each moment. Constantly changing, yet always being its essential self. It remains still as the seasons flow into one another, and as the weather changes moment by moment and day by day. Calmness abiding all change. In summer, there's no snow on the mountain except on the very high peaks or in the crags, shielded from direct sunlight. In the fall, the mountain may wear a coat of vibrant fire colors. In the winter, it may be blanketed with snow and ice. In any season, it may find itself at times enshrouded in clouds or fog, or pelted by freeze and rain. People may come to see the mountain and comment on how beautiful it is, or how it's not a good day to see the mountain. That it's too cloudy, rainy, foggy, or dark. None of this matters to the mountain, which remains at all times its essential self. Clouds may come and clouds may go. Tourists may like it or not. The mountain's magnificence and beauty are not changed one bit by whether people see it or not. Seen or unseen, in sun or clouds, broiling or frigid, day or night. It just sits being its essential self. At times visited by violent storms, buffeted by snow and rain and winds of unspeakable magnitude. Through it all, the mountain sits. Spring comes and birds sing in the trees once again. Leaves return, flowers bloom in the high meadows on the slopes. Streams overflow with the waters of the melting snow. Through it all, and continues to sit, unmoved by the weather, by what happens on the surface, by the world of appearances. In the same way as we sit in this meditation, we can learn to experience the mountain. We can embody the same unwavering stillness and rootedness in the face of everything that changes in our own lives, over seconds, over hours, over years. In our lives and in our meditation practice, we experience constantly a changing nature of our mind and body, of the outer world. We have our own periods of light and darkness, our own moments of color, and our moments of drabness. Certainly we experience storms of varying intensity and violence in our outer world and in our own minds and bodies, buffeted by high winds, by cold and rain. We endure periods of darkness and pain, as well as moments of joy, uplift, and pure bliss. Even our appearance changes constantly, experiencing a weather all of its own. By becoming the mountain in our meditation practice, we can link up with its strength and stability and adopt them for our own. We can use its energy to support our energy. So encounter each moment with mindfulness, equanimity, and clarity. It may help us to see that our thoughts and feelings, our preoccupations, our emotional storms and crises, even the things that happen to us, are very much like the weather on the surface of the mountain. We tend to take it all personally, but its strongest characteristic is that it is impersonal. The weather of our own lives is not to be ignored or denied. It's to be encountered, honored, felt, known for what it is, and held in that awareness. And in holding it in this way, we come to know a deeper silence and stillness and wisdom. Mountains have this to teach us and much more if we take the time to listen. So if you find that this resonated in some way with the strength and stability of the mountain in your sitting meditation today, it may be helpful to use it from time to time and remind yourself to be mindful and embrace stillness. So in the time that remains, sit with your mountain until I ring the chimes. You can come back to this meditation anytime you like. Again, it can be found at mindfulescapes.com. Namaste.